हेलो सर, हेलो।
गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन।
गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
गुड आफ्टरनून
सर।
ओके सो हैप्पी न्यू ईयर एवरीवन।
हैप्पी न्यू ईयर सर।
हैप्पी न्यू ईयर सर।
हैप्पी न्यू ईयर सर।
हैप्पी न्यू ईयर सर।
I hope you didn't forget the previous topics that I discussed. Okay. Did you forget all the RMS average calculation, or you keep remembering those? Did you remember?
Remembering, sir.
Okay. Very good. So today we are going to learn these topics. Okay, let me share the screen first. Okay, today we are going to discuss this phasor representation. I hope the screen is visible, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so after 2 minutes your class will start. Okay, let everyone join, then your class will start. And I hope today there is lab from 3, okay, for F3. Yes,
yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So within 2 minutes your class will start. That means from 2-6. Okay, let others join if anyone didn't.
Sir, someone is waiting.
Sir, Sohail is waiting, sir. Accept his request.
Okay. But here I am not seeing any request. Okay, tell him to join again.
Okay, sir.
Okay, the screen is visible now.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So today we are going to discuss this phasor representation. Okay, the calculation of RMS and average value was already done in previous class. So today we are going to discuss this phasor representation. And this portion, this phasor representation in phase lagging leading concept, that will help you in RLC series circuit lab. Okay, that you already, some of you already experimented. Okay, so without any delay, let's start.
Sir,
yes,
someone is waiting.
Who is waiting?
Sir, active audience, sir.
You know, no one is waiting here. Sorry. Okay, so this is the basic representation of the waveform that you can see here, that AT equals to A max sine omega t plus phi. Okay, this phi value represents, okay, this phi value represents the phase difference. Okay, in previous class, you learned this one, that A equals to A max sine omega t. Okay, that is the basic waveform that will start from 0, 0. Okay, it is the basic concept of the waveform, this one. Okay, but when we include this phase difference, that means that it is either away from the main 0, 0 point, or it starts before the 0, 0 point. Okay, that is the concept of lagging and leading. Okay, so here you can see that this is the, when your phase is phi is 0, the waveform looks like this. Okay, when the phase is positive, that means omega t plus phi, that means that waveform, this waveform started before 0, 0 point. Okay, this is your time axis, that is your x-axis, we represent time. So this waveform starts before the time t equals to 0. So this type of waveform is called the leading waveform. That means it leads the current reference axis by the angle this phi. Okay, it is the basic concept of leading. Now, next one is the lagging concept. That means it starts, it will start after t equals to 0. Okay, and our phase difference is phi. So it is written by minus phi. That is called basically the negative phase. Okay, so total three types of phase is here. Okay, first one is in phase system, that means when phi equals to 0. Then positive phase. What is positive phase? The waveform starts before the time t equals to 0. And what is negative phase? After t equals to 0, the waveform starts. That's why we extend this portion. Okay, this is the extended portion, as you can see, the dotted part. Okay, this portion is extended. Our actual waveform starts from here. Okay, now I am drawing cosine curve. Okay, the cosine curve will look like this. Okay, so I can say that this, if I extend this waveform, okay, this waveform will look like one sinusoidal waveform, correct? And we can say that this sinusoidal waveform starts this time before. Okay, so that is the conversion of cosine waveform to sine waveform. Okay, so I know that in trigonometrical chapter you learned this one, that is cos theta. What is the cos theta? If you convert this cos theta, how will you convert cos theta into sine theta? Anyone?
So root 1 minus sine square theta.
No, the trigonometrical conversion. Okay, I know that cos square theta plus sine square theta equals to 1, but
1 minus sine square theta.
Okay, just a minute. That is the trigonometric. Okay, just a minute. If I write like this, sine theta minus 90 degree with negative sign. Can I write like this?
Okay, sir.
Yes, sir.
Can I write like this? Okay, that means yes, what? That means what? It means that if we convert cosine waveform into sine waveform, if we convert from cosine to sine, the sinusoidal waveform will lead the reference axis by 90 degrees. It is the meaning. Okay, I know that you can write this one also, sine 90 minus theta. You can write like this. That means also the same thing. Okay, only this sinusoidal part means this sinus, this minus sign means the magnitude. Okay, I will show you later. Okay, so this is the basic concept of the in phase, positive phase and negative phase. So positive phase means the leading waveform. Okay, negative phase means lagging waveform. Okay, next, what is the concept of phasor? This kind of waveform can be drawn in a circle. Okay, look, this circle, all the angles are mentioned here, 30 degree, 60 degree, 90 degree, 120 degree, 150 degree, the movement of the angle. Okay, and what is your maximum value? Maximum magnitude, that is AM, that is the maximum value. So this is your radius of the circle. The maximum value is the radius of your circle. Okay, so look, this is the radius of your circle, right? Now, as you move from this portion, this 0, 0 point, along with the curve here, this angle also increases like this, okay, in anti-clockwise direction, right? This is your anti-clockwise direction. Okay, the clockwise direction will give you negative value, the anti-clockwise direction will give you positive value, right? So here, along with the angular movement, you are also getting the magnitude. Okay, and this arrow is called the rotating phasor. Okay, it rotates from 0 degree, then 30 degree, then 60 degree, then 90 degree, then 120, along with this waveform. Okay, now Some of you didn't understand this one. So how we can understand this in easiest way? Okay, so let me erase this part. Okay, just a minute. Okay, now all the written things are erased. Now suppose I want to know the value of this sine 45 degree. Okay, so what is the value of sine 45? That is 1 by root 2. Okay, and this am is here, that is the maximum value. So what is our value? Am by root 2. Okay, now if you go from this point, if you move from this point along with this waveform, so where is your 45 degree? Here. Okay, so this is your 45 degree. Okay, now I am drawing this 45 degree here. Okay, clear? Now what is the magnitude? How we are getting this magnitude? If you draw a perpendicular line here, okay, this value, this perpendicular line, okay, this will give you the this value am 1 by root 2. Okay, this is your radius. Okay, sine 45. So this value is your this value am by root 2. Okay, so likewise at 90 degree angle, this rotating phasor moves to this 90 degree point. Now what is your magnitude here? This perpendicular line will give you the magnitude. Okay, so as you can see, along with the change with the angle, the magnitude also increases or decreases, or negative value or positive value, whatever value you want, you can generate. Okay, so this is the concept of phasor. This arrow is basically called the phasor. Okay, now what is the in phase system? Now you can see the two waveforms are drawn here. Okay, so two waveforms you can see here. Okay, one is the voltage waveform, this blue one is the voltage waveform, and the red one is the current waveform, and they both start from this 0,0 point. Okay, and they both end at 2 pi. The theta equal to 2 pi. So that means there is no phase difference. So these are called the in phase system. Okay, what is the difference? The difference is in their magnitude, not in phase. So that's why these voltage waveform and current waveform, these two waveforms are called here the in phase waveforms. And how we can represent this in phasor? In phasor, like this, in x-axis I, okay, current waveform, and in x-axis V, voltage waveform. Okay, if this voltage phasor moves like this, then there is one phase angle difference. Then we will say that no, the voltage waveform and the current waveform, they are not in phase. They are either lagging or leading based on their phasor movement. Okay, now next one is the lagging concept. So what is the meaning of lagging? Lagging means the waveform starts after t equals to zero, after the reference point. Okay, that is the meaning of lagging. When you are playing game in mobile, okay, some you are saying that no, the game is lagging. That means what? It means somewhere due to the network connection or due to slow processor, your game is not working properly. It shows the graphical interface or it shows the picture in delay time. So this timing, this is called the delay. That's why it is called the lagging. Okay, now here you can see the voltage waveform starts from 0, 0. So that's why it is in x-axis. Okay, and this current waveform, that is the red color waveform, the current waveform is lagging by 30 degree. Okay, suppose this angle is 30 degree. So the we will say that current waveform is lagging by 30 degree. Okay, with respect to this voltage waveform. So we are drawing in phasor waveform, in phasor representation, we put the current phasor in 30 degree lagging position. Okay, and what will be our equation? Equation will be Im sine omega t minus theta. So what is this theta value? Theta value is your 30 degree. Okay, so till now, if you have any query, you can ask. Otherwise, I will proceed.
Sir, could you again explain the lagging theory?
Okay, fine. See, you have played PUBG or some other games also, right?
Yes.
Have you played? Okay. So when you say that, no, the game is lagging, it means what? It means due to the slow processor or whatever be your network problem, due to any reason, your game must run smoothly, but it is not running. The display is showing the pictures in some delay time, right? That means there is some delay in your system. That is called basically lagging. Here, the blue waveform is the voltage waveform that starts from t equals to zero as per this axis, reference axis. Okay, so this blue color waveform is your voltage waveform and the current waveform is lagging. That means it starts after the voltage. Okay, it does, it is not starting along with the voltage. It starts after some angle difference. That means maybe 10 degree lagging, maybe 20 degree lagging, but there is a lagging. Okay, that means it has, this current waveform has some delay time. Okay, so that's why the current waveform starts from here. Okay, not along with the voltage. So what is the lagging angle here? The phase difference is 30 degree.
30 degree.
Now is it okay? Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is the waveform, how you can represent. But in our electrical power transmission system, okay, there are millions of voltage waveforms, millions of signal waveforms. So it is impossible to identify just by drawing the waveforms one by one. So that's why the phasor concept we are taking. Okay, so in just phasor, look, without drawing this total waveform, without drawing this total waveform just by an arrow, we can represent the voltage. Okay, so this is called the voltage phasor. It is called the voltage phasor. Okay, and next one is the current, the red color waveform. Okay, and the current waveform is obviously lagging. That means it has some delay. How much? 30 degree angle. Okay, so draw the 30 degree delay, right? And then draw the current waveform, current phasor, not waveform, current phasor. Okay, so this is the phasor representation. Okay, Now in F1 they have completed the RLC series circuit. Okay, to the F1 students, is the concept clear? The lagging, leading?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now,
sir, sir, how 30 degrees, sir? How you are calculating the angle 30?
Okay, you can angle by the protractor. You can calculate, na? 30 degree. You have compass,
sir,
you have protractor.
Sir, is there any formula of calculating angle?
Angle calculate, see this angle calculation, okay, I know. Okay, so this angle calculation can be done from the elements, okay, from the RLC value. Okay, I will show you, don't worry. Till now, just let's know that this is the angle 30 degree and after 30 degree, the current waveform starts. Okay, I will tell you how this 30 degree is calculated. See, this is just one example. Okay, you can say that this is our voltage waveform that starts from here. Okay, this is our current waveform that starts from here. So this angle difference is around 90 degree. I can say that this is just one example. Okay, and this leading, lagging angle, this angle can be calculated. Yes, very good question. This angle can be calculated using the resistor, inductor, capacitor. That means whatever elements you are using in the circuit, that will help you to calculate this phase angle difference. Okay, I will show you. You have to wait for one class also.
Sir?
Yes?
From the formula A sin omega t plus phi, can't we find the value of phi?
Repeat again, I cannot understand your question.
From the formula A sin omega t plus phi, which we have taught right now, can we find phi?
Yes, obviously that phi is the phase difference and that phase difference is depending on the elements, what you are using in your circuit.
Phase difference, maybe it's an angle.
Yes, phase difference is angle, that is not basically time. Because yes, you can see here, the x-axis is your omega t. Okay, theta equals to omega t. See, there are two types of waveform. Okay, in one case, we put the x-axis as time. Okay, in another case, we put instead of t, omega t. That means theta, the angle difference. Okay.
Yes.
Right. So here theta is taken. That means the phase. Okay. How much is the propagation of the waveform? How the waveform is propagating from one point to another? That is called the phase. Okay. And what is phase difference? The angle difference between two waveforms. In simple language, the angle difference between the waveform is called phase difference. Okay, so suppose here the phase difference is 30 degree and how you can calculate this phase difference, you have to wait for another class. Okay, I will show you, that is already in your syllabus. I will show you. Okay, but step by step. Okay, now this one is the leading waveform. Okay, this is the blue waveform. This blue waveform is the voltage waveform, right? And the violet waveform is the current waveform. Okay, now this current waveform, how can you say that current waveform is leading or lagging? You have to extend it to see. Okay, you have to extend it. Otherwise, you cannot see whether it is leading or lagging because you have to complete the waveform. Okay, this waveform is incomplete. You can see it. Okay, this waveform is incomplete. The sinusoidal waveform starts from here. Okay, but it basically, if you extend it in minus x-axis, then you will see that this is your angle difference. This is your angle difference. And from this drawing, you can say that the current waveform starts before the voltage waveform. Okay, that means the current waveform is leading the voltage waveform by angle 90 degrees. Okay, so that is the leading sinusoidal waveform. Okay, now if here, see, all the waveforms we need to complete as per the sinusoidal curve. Okay, if I erase this part, okay, try to understand this one. This one is very important. Otherwise, the phasor concept will remain incomplete. Okay, now look at this curve. Now the, okay, now here, this waveform, the voltage waveform is sinusoidal, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, but is the current waveform sinusoidal?
No, sir.
No, that means what? We have to either extend it or remove any portion so that we can convert the incomplete waveform to complete one. Am I clear?
Yes.
Okay, so we need to complete this waveform. See, this is the smallest work that we can do. Okay, there are two processes to complete the waveform or convert this waveform as per sinusoidal. Number one, we can extend this portion, okay, or we can remove this portion to this portion. So which one is easier?
Extension.
Extension is easier than removing the long portion. So that's why we are extending. Okay, this question, this removing, the removing this extra part, this question was already asked in some interview. Okay, that they asked that, okay, I am giving you two waveforms. Okay, these two waveforms I am giving you. Okay, now tell me whether it is leading or lagging, right? And the student asked that this second waveform, this long waveform is A, second waveform is B. Okay, the B waveform is leading. He can ask this, he asks that. Okay, now the teacher asks that how you can show sure that whether it is leading or lagging. You are saying that the B waveform is leading, but how? The student said that, okay, if I can extend this, then only I can say that it is leading. Then the teacher said that now if I remove this portion, then also the waveform converts into sinusoidal part. Okay, and now I can say now the B waveform is lagging. Is my question clear to everyone?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
If I remove this long portion, this violet part, if I remove this part, then this is another sinusoidal waveform, and we can say that it is lagging. Right. So which one is right? Which one is wrong? How can you understand that? The main concept is which one is taking less time? Okay. In easiest language, which one is taking less time? Whether removing or adding, which one is taking less time? Obviously, adding is taking less time. Okay. So this B waveform is leading in nature. Okay, so since this one is leading, so I can say that this is plus theta. Okay, because it already started before the voltage waveform. The current waveform already started before the voltage waveform. And how much angle it is leading? 90 degrees. Suppose 90 degrees. Okay, this one is 90 degree leading. So what will be the phasor diagram? Since the voltage waveform starts from the reference axis, so this value, the voltage phasor must be in x-axis, okay? And then we will move in positive. And I already told you that if you move in clockwise direction, then it is negative. Okay, because this is the quadrant rule. This is your first quadrant, this is second quadrant, this is third, and this one is fourth. Okay, now if you move from this position to this point, so you are moving in clockwise direction. So this is nothing but the negative angle. Okay, if you move in anti-clockwise direction, that will give you plus angle. That means leading in nature. Okay, so here you can see that leading is your current, leading phasor is your current, and how much angle? 90 degree leading. Okay, now is the lagging leading in phase concept clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Everyone, it is clear now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Fine. Now, this is the relation that you already know. Okay, I just noted here for your better understanding. Okay, the sinusoidal and cosine wave relationship. That means, suppose here is one cosine waveform. Okay, all the waveforms are sinusoidal. So you have to convert this cosine waveform into sinusoidal waveform. Okay, to check whether this waveform is leading or lagging. Correct. So how will you convert this? So you have to use this relationships. Okay, this mathematical identities, this trigonometrical identities you have to use. Okay, now phasor addition. Now this portion, I hope it is already, you are already familiar with this calculation. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
That is the parallelogram rule. Correct. So in this, what we are going to do, this is your one phasor, this is your another phasor, right? And we can say that V1 phasor, this V1 phasor, this one is your V1 phasor, this one is your V2 phasor. Okay, so we can say that V1 phasor is leading the V2 phasor by angle 60 degree. Okay, this one I can say. Now, what is your resultant voltage? The resultant voltage will be the addition of the vectors or phasors, right? So this Vt value is V1 plus V2. Right now, arithmetical process, how will you solve? You have to extend it. Okay, you have to extend this one also. Now this one vector and this is same, these vectors are same. Okay, this angle is 60 degree. Okay, so this V1's cos 60 value is this, sin 60 value is this. Okay, then use the Pythagoras theorem here. Okay, in this part, then only you can calculate the magnitude of the resultant. Okay, and how will you calculate this angle? The angle calculation will be easy. What is the angle calculation? I am writing that angle as phi. Okay, so phi equals to y by x, that means this perpendicular by base. So What is the perpendicular value? That is V1 sine theta divided by V2 plus V1 cos theta, and this value is your nothing but tan phi. Okay, so from here you can calculate the phi value. Okay, so phi value when you are getting, you can say that Vt, that means the this resultant voltage is leading by, is leading the V2 vector, Vt vector is leading the V2 vector by this phi angle. This is your complete answer. Okay, next one is the mathematical formulation. Okay, what I already told you. Now, this is the numerical that we are going to solve today. Okay, in a circuit, an inductor of 20 millihenry is connected across the source, due to which the current passing through it being 10 sine 314 t. Now, find out the total voltage drop and equation of the voltage across it. So the current value is already given. Here, look, it is 10 sine 314 t. Okay. So you can calculate the voltage across the inductor, correct? So L into di dt. Now calculate, put the L value 20 millihenry. So the voltage is 62.8 cosine 314 t. Okay, now you have to convert this sinusoidal value, this cosine value to sinusoidal value. Okay. That will be 62.8 sine 314 t plus 90 degree. Okay, because sine 90 plus theta is also cos theta. Correct. So now, if you put this VL and IT, you can see which one is leading, which one is lagging. Okay. Now try to draw this in your copy. Okay. We are drawing only phasors, not waveforms, right? So here the current value you can see, that is 10 sine omega t, that is 314 t. So here this one, this waveform, the current waveform starts from 0 0, correct? So our phasor of current will be in x-axis. Is it okay? Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
No, okay. Sir. Okay. Why no, sir? Where you are not understanding?
It is start from zero.
See, what is the phase difference here in current waveform? Is there any phase difference?
No, sir.
That means the phi value is zero. What is the meaning of phi value zero? It starts from the 0 0 point. That's why it starts from 0 0 point.
Okay.
Okay. And since the I value starts from 0 0 point, it must be in x axis, along the x axis. Is it okay? That's why the current waveform is in x axis. Okay. The current phasor is in x axis. Now, look, what is the VL value? The VL value is magnitude different, okay, and plus 90 degree. What is the meaning of plus 90 degree? Plus 90 degree means it is leading. Exactly, it is leading. So in this y axis, we are going to write the VL. Now, is that okay? Do you understand this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
That means what you can say? You can say that the voltage across the inductor will always lead by 90 degree. with respect to the current waveform. Clear? That means we can say that the voltage VL will always leads the current by 90 degree angle in case of the inductor. Always remember that in case of inductor, voltage always leads the current. The VL, the voltage across the inductor, always leads the current. Okay, now I have one simple question to ask. With this, I am concluding today's class. Okay, the other numericals are there. I am not going there. Okay, just tell me one thing. Here the current is 10 sine 314 t. Okay, and this current I am passing through one resistor of 20 ohm. Okay, so what will be the lagging leading condition here? Please tell me, try to find this out. Okay, this current I am flowing through one resistor of 20 ohm. Okay, what will be the relation between the phasor relation between the voltage and current, whether it is leading or lagging, what will happen?
Sir, lagging.
Why lagging? Please explain.
Sir, it is a resistor.
No, that is, see, without any proof, how are you saying that it is lagging?
Sir, I think it will neither lag or neither lead.
Why? I am asking why.
Sir, because in case of resistor, the current does not lead or lag.
So voltage will lead or lag. The current is not going anywhere. That means voltage will lead or lag. No. Okay.
No, sir, voltage will not lead or not lag.
Then what will happen? That will be in phase. No phase difference will be there. Okay, total three cases I told you. One is in phase system. Second one, lagging system. Third one, leading system. Okay, now in case of inductor, check in this question. In case of inductor, I am telling you that VL, the voltage across the inductor, that is developing, that will always be in leading. Okay, now in case of resistor, what will happen? In case of resistor, the voltage across the resistor, VR equals to IR. Is that okay to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so what is the value of I? That is 10 sine omega t. What is the value of omega? 314. Okay. Now, into the resistance value, that is 20. Okay. So just multiply. This will be 200 sine omega t. So in between VR and I, is there any phase difference?
No, sir.
No, sir.
So, how you are saying it is lagging, it is leading? Okay, see, whatever you are saying, try to give me one proof that, yes, sir, I have calculated this one. That's why I am saying this. Okay, I have shown you that VR equals to IR. I value is already known to you and R value is 20. So VR value is 20 into 10, magnitudes will be multiplied, 200 and sine omega t. So now if you draw this one in the reference system, how will it look like? The current waveform is this. Okay, that is less because 10 is the magnitude and sine omega t. Is there any phi? Is there any phase difference? No. So that's why it will start from the 0, 0 point. Is that clear? Now, next, I am drawing the VR. Okay. Since here the maximum value is 200, so it is greater. And is there any phase difference? Omega t plus phi. Is there any phi value?
No, sir.
No. That means it will start from 0, 0 point. So what is the type of this system? This is called in phase system. Okay, total three types of phase systems are there. One is in phase, where the phase difference between two waveforms are zero. Next one is the leading phase system. Here you are seeing the leading one. Okay. Now, if we connect one capacitor, then you will see that the current is here. Okay. But voltage is in minus y axis. Okay. So at this case, we will say that current is leading with respect to VC by angle 90 degree, or you can say that VC is lagging the current by 90 degree. Both are equally correct. Is this okay to everyone? Is this concept clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
No confusion, na? Okay, very good. So with this calculation, I am concluding today's class, and in the evening, okay, I will give you one numerical based on this in WhatsApp group. Okay, try to solve that. Okay, try to solve that based on this leading lagging concept. I will give you one numerical. Try to solve that. Okay, so now all of you give your attendance in the chat box. And thank you, everyone.
Sir, please explain last line of the capacitor.
Yes, capacitor, I will ask. I will tell you everything. Okay. Today, we did not have any time because for F3 batch, we have another lab. Okay. In next class, I will discuss about the capacitor. If we connect one capacitor, what will happen? Okay. How the VC is lagging, I will explain everything. Okay. Okay.
Thank you.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Thank you, sir.
सर पिछले दिन सर हम सर कॉल किए थे आपको सर वो सर प्रोजेक्ट का लेके
बोलो
सर तो आपने सर कुछ बताया नहीं
कौन सा बोलो वो आरएलसी
नहीं सर प्रोजेक्ट ये कैलिब्रेशन प्रोजेक्ट का सर
अच्छा प्रोजेक्ट मत बोलो लैब एक्सपेरिमेंट बोलो प्रोजेक्ट अलग चीज होता है ठीक है द प्रोजेक्ट इज टोटली डिफरेंट देन योर लैब एक्सपेरिमेंट ओके हां यस व्हाट वाज योर प्रॉब्लम
सर प्रॉब्लम ये है सर मैंने मेरा फ्रंट पेज अपलोड नहीं हुआ था फिर मैंने बाद में सर उसको री अपलोड किया
अच्छा
सर तो आप बोले थे कि चेक करके फिर से बताएंगे
ओके ओके सॉरी आई टोटली फॉरगॉट ओके योर नेम इज रोशन सिंह योर रोल नंबर
सर 200 2070
लास्ट टू डिजिट 70 ओके टुडे आई विल चेक एंड आई विल टेल यू ओके
ओके सर थैंक यू सर
ओके थैंक यू Okay, everyone, give your attendance. If you have given, you can leave the meeting.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.